We are at war, but it is a farce. God has made available a great amount of information to support his children in this world. Satan, the enemy of the people of God, has been put into a tight corner, and it is done. Well, it is a war. We are at war, but it is a farce, for the enemy has already been taken down. All his schemes, calculations, manipulations, and lies are things that the people of God are able to withstand without ever looking at them. Whatsoever the enemy can plant on the road to ensnare the people of God has already been uncovered by the manifold wisdom of God that he has given to the church, Ephesians chapter 3 verse 10. The natural world in which Satan is locked cannot compete with this wisdom of God. No one can be too smart for God. Therefore, of the schemes of the devil are just dirty tricks that he plays on himself. Christ, after having overcome the system of this world, took his wisdom and understanding and gave them as a gift to the whole earth. The wisdom of God is available to all to access. Again and again, people choose to use this wisdom and walk in victory through faith and by grace. No one is demanded to work or fight for this victory anymore, as it is written, "But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ," 1 Corinthians 15:57. The story in the end became a fairy tale, the story of a prince who went to a land far away, the world, and cut off the head of the dragon, Satan, to save from his hand the beautiful prince, the church. This story sounds so good that it is hard to believe, but the prophet Isaiah asks, "Who hath believed our report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed?" Isaiah chapter 53 verse 1. The good message of the gospel needs to be believed. The great arm of God has been revealed. We need to accept the mighty revelation that God has shown us and keeps on revealing to us daily. It is only when we believe this great message that it becomes beneficial to us. For the king has sent his servant to invite people to the marriage of the land and his bride, Revelation chapter 19 verse 6. The invitation has been sent to the inhabitants of the earth. Everyone is welcome to attend this great party. People have to make the choice of attending this great party. Enough information has been shared in this book to enable you to reevaluate the important role that choices play in our lives. Life is a series of choices put together. God has not written any one destiny for anybody, but he has made a master plan that provides good life and a future to all, Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11. The prophet Moses, when talking to the people about life and choices, said, "This day I call the heavens and the earth as witnesses against you that I have set before you life and death, blessings and curses. Now choose life, so that you and your children may live," Deuteronomy 30-18. We have to make the choice of life. To choose life is to choose Jesus, for he is the way, the truth, and the life, John chapter 14 verse 6. We are commanded to make this choice. No one will ever be able to force us to accept this recommendation from the King of the universe. Those who have already accepted the call of life from God can be assured that the struggles and fights they are seeing now are just a big farce, for God himself said, "Be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world," John chapter 16 verse 33. God, time and choices. This is taken from the book, God, Time and Choices. Get the book on Amazon now. Link in the description. Like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more video like this.